I go out to remote and regional communities all over Australia and provide hearing assessments and training to Aboriginal communities.
To close the gap for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children who have a high rate of middle ear disease. And so my role in the HAPEE program, which is an acronym for the Hearing Assessment Program Early Ears, which is run by Hearing Australia, is to go out into the Aboriginal communities and provide hearing assessments and training to the Aboriginal community. So I was really motivated to bring my team together around a better way of working. And so what I found was the information I was getting was often in a fragmented form. So they're gathering a lot of the information and having to disseminate it a lot, not just to the audiologist, but to the other stakeholders involved in the program. And that's where I came across Microsoft Power Apps, and it really ticked all the boxes.
End of 2019, I started working on Power Apps and Power Platform. Over there, I started to automate much of the manual processes we have in Hearing Australia using Power Apps and Power Automate.
So obviously, I have no IT experience. I didn't even know how to put a table in Excel, and you need that basic skill in order to create a Canvas app. And so really I relied heavily on Umar for technical knowledge.
So I started to learn about what are the happy pain points. So the major one was, as Jackie mentioned, the data was scattered, right? So she was using Excel to, you know, and as a data source for Canvas apps. So I told her that it would be better off if she could, you know, use CDS, which will open a new world to her.
Picking up model-driven apps and Canvas apps, Microsoft has done a fantastic job on education and created a software system that is really intuitive and easy to use. But the part that I really needed help with was how IT systems work. I had no idea that my solution was going to need to be tested. I didn't know what a user story was or what a deployment pipeline was. And so that's where I really relied on Umar to sort of teach me and guide me and do all of the background work necessary in order to make an application the size of the one that I've built for HAPEE successful.
Jackie is doing the is at the ground, right? So she knows what's about the business in and out. So she came in helping out in regards to doing creating entities and tables and fields, those kind of stuff, which are very labor intensive. So that's where Jackie helped me in that sense. So what I was able to do more was, you know, put in more effort in the architecture point of view.
So one of the reasons why the HAPEE app is so successful is because we're really getting the most we can out of the few developers that we have. And so because I'm so close to the business and I am one of the users of the application, it means that I can build something and then Umar can come in and use his expertise to really sprinkle the magic of code-first development where and if needed. HAPEE is now grown to the size of a small business. We have over 100 people working on our team all over Australia, and connecting all of our information through the model-driven app just means that we can continue to grow and evolve as a program. And my favorite thing is that as an audiologist, I can now be out in the community with no internet and find the most up-to-date information on my phone offline. It was a game changer.